Hi, and welcome to the Bruriah Arts Festival. Every year, one of the main highlights of the Bruriah High School experience is the mother-daughter production. Last year, COVID stopped us in our tracks and almost managed to stop us this year as well. But we rose to the challenge. We were determined to put on a musical without a stage. In the words of this year's producer, we thought outside the box while putting ourselves literally inside the Zoom box to create a festival. Our production this year features the unique aspects of the Bruriah mother-daughter: dance, choir, song dance, all directed by our students themselves. Offering this production virtually allows us to highlight student artwork in addition to the traditional pieces. It gives us great pleasure to offer our students the opportunity to express themselves artistically once again, especially after a year of limited connections and limited opportunity for expression. We have enjoyed watching the energy in the building as the students prepared for the filming. David HaMelech ends Sefer Tehillim with the line, Kol HaNishama Tehallel Ka. In fact, in Shacharit, this parak is included, and that last line is repeated twice. It's generally understood to mean, let each soul praise Hashem. An alternate reading, perhaps is valid, translates that phrase as, let each part of a person's soul praise Hashem. David HaMelech is calling upon us to use all of our talents in praise of Hashem. And so our students have done in this evening's virtual performance. We're so pleased to have you join us this evening. We hope you walk away from tonight's performance feeling uplifted. To the rest of the administration, especially Dina, thank you for all the hours you put in re-envisioning this opportunity for our students and for carrying it out so beautifully. To our students, thank you for turning a challenging experience into an uplifting one. Thank you for putting your energies into everything you do and for sharing your talents at Bruriah. May you continue to build on your talents and use them l'shem shamayim. And to our audience, thank you once again for joining us. And now, sit back and enjoy the show.
You know that, right?
Yeah. You've only even told me that just about every day since I told you I was moving.
Well, it is a big deal, Burley. You know how obsessed I am with houses. I even go on Zillow for fun. So, how big is your new room? Is it nice? Ooh, pink walls?
Yeah, I think it's a decent size, and my mom and I settled on gray walls. But I think it'll look pretty.
Don't worry. You're super creative. I'm sure it'll look great.
Yeah, I hope so. I don't know.
Why? You got to live in New York City and go to a big school. You even get to live near Times Square. And I heard the lights really never turn off.
Oh, Talia, New York.
Are you mocking my dreams of becoming a New Yorker on Broadway star? Waving through a window.
I know, and I'm excited, but it's a huge adjustment.
Don't worry, Orly. We're only one call away.
Thanks.
Orly, let's go. Let's get everything packed up by 8 p.m. so movers can leave right away. We don't want to distract you. Let's get going.
Yeah. Bye. I love you guys. I'm going to miss you more than anything.
We'll miss you too. And we'll miss your famous cousin, Mrs. Stern.
Oh, Talia, you girls are so sweet. I'm going to miss having you around. Bye.
Bye.
Hey, how are you doing? Are you excited about tomorrow?
I don't know.
Oh, Orly, I know you're nervous about the move, but you're going to do great. You're an amazing girl. You're going to make a ton of friends. And just think about all the amazing opportunities we'll have because of Dad's new job.
Yeah, you're right. It's going to be good. I'm just freaking myself out for no reason.
You'll be just fine. All right, stop stalling. Finish packing up.
Hey, you were the one who interrupted me.
Oh, shush.
Shiru, oh, Shiru,
Orly.
Okay. Hello? Anyone home? Yeah? Hi, I'm Atara. Our moms are talking outside and your mom said I could just come in and introduce myself. I brought cookies!
Oh, thank you.
Oh, I'm Orly. Yeah, I know. I already know everything about you. Did you know that we're the same age? No, you didn't because I didn't tell you that until now. But yeah, we're the same age and we're going to be in the same class and the same school. It's going to be so fun. I'm so excited to introduce you to all my friends. I already told them all about you. It's going to be the best.
Wow, I don't even know how to respond.
Oh, I'm sorry. I just talked about my thing where I talk about my little minute, but it's fine. I'm somewhere, so we're all good. So, LA, huh? You ever meet anyone?
Yeah. I've met a bunch, but it doesn't happen as often as people think.
Yeah. Same thing in Manhattan. Everyone thinks they're gonna meet all these people just walking around, but really? No one. So disappointing.
Yeah, it's kind of how it is with LA. Big common misconception. Wait, you mentioned we're going to the same school, right?
Yeah.
Tell me about it. Is there anything I should know?
Don't use the water fountains. They're very unsanitary and very gross. Also, don't eat the mashed potatoes from the cafeteria. Worst mistake of your life if you do. I did once and I was sick for weeks. Oh my god, the nurse hated me. I was there every day. And also, never, and I mean never, make Mrs. Schwab mad.
Oh my god, Mrs. Schwab?
She's only the meanest, scariest, hardest algebra teacher in all the land. One time, she made four girls cry in one day. Usually it's one or two, but never four. And to this day, nobody knows what happened.
Sounds scary.
Yeah.
Never.
For your sake, I hope so too. Anyway, I think it would make the most sense if I come tomorrow and pick you up because we're gonna be walking in the same direction, you know? Sound cool?
Yeah, sounds great, thank you.
Okay, I'll see you tomorrow!
Okay.
I'm Atara.
1, 2, 3, go!
Zeke Kiriasi, Kalalokim Elyon, Behashem Es Nivasi, Besimcha Uvigayon, Yishayir Yerushamrin
time. I'm so excited. I'm going to introduce you to all my friends. They're going to love you.
I'm so excited to meet them too. Wait, there's Leia, Shayna, and who?
Chana. She's really smart. She's going to help you with everything. One time, I like was like flunking out of like this one class, and she helped me so much. Oh my god. She's the best nose ever.
Chana.
Here we are. Hey guys. This is the new girl I've been talking about, Orly. That is Leia, Shayna, and Fauna.
Hi, welcome. It's nice to meet you.
Hey, I forgot that I told us so much about you.
Uh-huh.
I do.
Hey, you're like insanely pretty. Like, your eyebrows are always perfectly.
Oh, sorry. You know that's not weird. Thank you.
See, I told you I love you.
Wait, you're from LA.
So does that mean you
I already gave her the famous question answer. Did you meet anyone? No, no, no. She said, unfortunately, no.
Oh, that'd be cool.
Well, actually, there was this time when I met Mordecai Shapiro.
Wait, like the Mordecai Shapiro?
Yeah, and he was really nice. He doesn't even live in LA. He was just there for concerts.
That's so cool. I've actually met him a couple times to see my brother sings backup for him.
Whoa. First of all, why did you never tell me that? Because I've known you for like way longer than a day, so I feel like I should have known that. And also, why did you tell me? I'm like, he's literally his number one fan.
Not why, I was kind of starstruck. I don't know how I forgot about it yesterday.
It happened.
And therefore, the answer is negative 213. All right, girls, please prepare for a quiz tomorrow on units 3, 4, and 5.
A quiz already? I don't even understand what's going on. Powers, right, Mrs. Schwab, is impossible.
Is there a problem, Mr.?
No, I just don't understand what we learned, and I don't feel comfortable for a quiz tomorrow.
Well, what didn't you understand, Miss Stern?
I don't know. I just don't get it.
Well, I can't help you if you don't tell me what you didn't understand. Do you think I read minds?
No, I just...
You just what, Miss Stern? Are you gonna go and play the whole I'm the new kid and this is all confusing at heart part for me because I don't suggest you try that with me? Back in my day, if we had problems, we used our brains and figured it out ourselves. Did I ever tell you the time I went to Australia and everyone was driving on the wrong side of the road? Well, I turned on my brain and realized it wasn't everyone else driving on the wrong side of the road. I was. Nowadays, your generation can't do anything for yourselves. You just complain and expect everyone else to fix it for you. Do you know how many car accidents I would have caused if I did that? You kids need to learn how to be more self-sufficient and independent. Do you understand me, mister?
Yes.
And because you clearly can't seem to express yourself, I cannot be of any help. Maybe if you come into class tomorrow with a new attitude, you'll be able to understand my curriculum. curriculum. Until then, ask one of your classmates. I can't help you.
If you need any help, just let me know.
Thanks. So, how was your first day? Who's your favorite teacher? What's your class?
It was okay. I don't know. I like most of them.
You're quieter than usual. Something happened?
No, I'm fine. I'm just exhausted. Thank you for introducing me to your friends, though. That was really nice of you.
Yeah, what are friends for, you know?
My room I sent you?
Yes, and I love it. I also love the cute gold chandelier. It really adds that pop color. Good call to go with the gray walls.
I agree. It's really cute. But wait, today was your first day, right? How was?
That question again. It was pretty much the worst day ever.
What do you mean?
Hate it here.
Any day in New York is a great day.
Talia, let Orly tell us what happened. Is everything all right?
Yeah, well, we have this teacher, Mrs. Schwab, and she's impossible. She humiliated me in front of my whole class.
Oh no, what happened?
I don't really want to talk about it. Speaking of math, I have to go study for this quiz tomorrow.
Okay,
bye.
We'll speak tomorrow. Bye.
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 Yeah? I didn't mean to eavesdrop, but I heard you on the phone. What happened in math class today?
Well, my teacher basically said that I was dumb. And all I asked her to do was clarify something. And then she humiliated me in front of my whole class.
You know, when I was in high school, I was actually in a very similar situation. I had this teacher, Mrs. Blanche. She was impossible. She gave so many assignments and so little time to do the work. I hated her. But after a few months, I realized something. I was going to be in her class whether I liked it or not, and I had two choices. Either I could be upset and angry about it, or I could still try and enjoy the year and find all the good that there still was. And I chose the second one. You can't control things that are going on around you. You can control the way you feel. I tried to look around me and see all the positive that there still was. And slowly, slowly, I really started to enjoy her class. I gained so much from it. You can only control the way you feel. Look at all the positive things that have happened. You made so many new friends, and it's only the first day.
Yeah, you're right. Thanks, Mom.
I love you, sweetie.
Love you, too.
There's literally no dairy in it.
Only you would get sick from mashed potatoes.
Well, someone's in a good mood today.
Just trying out a new perspective.
My mom says I should try that sometimes, but I think I'm pretty okay.
Hey, guys.
Hi.
Oh, Orly, are you ready for today's algebra quiz?
Not really. Actually, would you mind helping me? I'm still having trouble with a couple of things.
Yeah, sure. I'd love to. What you guys do is math.
5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Pencils down. Everyone's been giving your quizzes. Well, 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 Miss Stern. I see you put in the hard work.